It really gives me a great deal of pleasure to introduce a young man who graduated in 1969 from Santa Ana High School. He took the starring lead in Bye Bye Birdie, Brigadoon, and Music Man on this very stage. Bob Gulley is a very talented singer and songwriter. He's traveled around the United States, and we're really pleased that he's giving his time and his band is here today to entertain us. So, without further ado, Bob Gulley.
Man. his heart were stored. His only son was my friend Joe. He joined the army back in 1964.
So in love, oh, we took our arms to meet you.
still so far away.
Hey! very stage right here. And we're going to do one more song that's called Fantasy, and then a brief intermission, and then we're going to bring out... What's his name? You know what I'm talking about. So, thanks again, and here it is.
See you. You say that I
strength, still love me.
I'm gonna do at this moment.
precious ground to walk on. If I could just hold you.
Some of those guys. This is song, it's on my brand new album.
The album is called The Best of Bill Medley. Took him 25 years to find the best. So this is on that album, it's called American Rock and Roll. May I have a drink? Okay. Here's to everybody. It's just water, honest, it's just water. God, you've been coming out here. I didn't lose any, I didn't have any to lose. What's on the next?
So what?
What?
So
How was it? Had a good catch of a little beat to it, huh? I know that song. Give me a G. What key was that? Give me a G. So, so fine. Now give me a W flat. So, I'm just trying to impress my school teachers. Now we actually can call out numbers. So fine. So fine. So fine. This next song is a tune that is on the brand new album, the best of Bill Medley album, and this is a tune that was written by, I think, the greatest songwriting team in the whole world. They wrote songs like You've Lost My Love and Feeling, Soul and Inspiration, Brown Eyed Woman, a lot of those songs. And this is a tune that they wrote for Roy Orbison, and Roy passed on the song for some reason, so Gene Pitney recorded, became a number one hit record for him, and, 60 or 61, and we just redid it. It's called I'm Gonna Be Strong. Stay. mean, see, I flew in from Germany late last night, so I'm still on a little bit of jet lag and a whole bunch of things. So this is just water to try and keep my my throat dry. That keeps it wet. I can keep it wet. Okay, matter of fact, speaking of sending a hike, I'd like to dedicate my whole show to a gentleman, Mr. Jack Coleman, that passed away a couple of years ago. He was wonderful. When I was going to school here, he was he really honestly tried to get me involved in the school activities, and I did okay in choir, but he just was he would take us, like three or four of us guys at the Hollywood, and watch some of the recording and all that. And in about 1972 or 73, I had lost my voice and couldn't sing at all. I was told that I would never sing again. And I ran into Jack Coleman, and he said, I can fix that. And it took, after about 2 years of a lesson every day, two lessons every day, it finally started coming back slowly but surely. And the only drag about having the hit Time of My Life was that Jack wasn't here to see it. But I know he saw it. I know he's watching now. But so this is, this song isn't for Jack, but I want to dedicate my show to him, because without him, believe me, I wouldn't be here. Another song that I don't know, and this is a song that Elton John recorded, and actually recorded a few years ago, and then it became a hit again last year or so. It's a beautiful song, and it was written about a woman that I can remember going to the movie show and watching, and absolutely fell in love with her, probably like every other guy. And every time I saw her, it always made me feel real sad and happy at the same time. Wonderful actress. This is about Marilyn Monroe. This is called Candle in the Wind.
Candle burned out.
seems to me you lived your life like a candle in the wind, never knowing could have cling to when the rain set in. Thank you.
Two young ladies, the righteous sisters. First off, this is Miss Lori Martin.
Lori.
And Pat Paul.
Lori.
We're going to feature them, right now. Doing a song at, what? Is this right? Oh, the drummer. She. And he's the guy that has dirty pictures on me. Hot drums from Beaumont, California, right out here. And he was born and raised there. He is one of my dearest friends. You can tell, I just... He is one of my dearest friends, and he is my road manager, Mr. Dave. Okay, here's a song that I had the pleasure of recording with Miss Jennifer Warnes in the movie Dirty Dancing. I understand there's going to be a Dirty Dancing 2. I don't know when it's coming out. It's called Seriously Dirty Dancing. But actually there is another movie coming out. But I'm very, very excited about this song. It was became a number one hit, I think, last year. Won a Grammy from it. It won the Academy Award. And a lot of wonderful things. I can't take credit for some of those, but I will with the help of you. This is called, and I am having the time of my life. I'll tell you why. At home, or she's out here somewhere, I have my little two-year-old baby daughter, McKenna. That's not what I'm thinking. Thank you, it was my pleasure. And the main reason I'm having the time of my life is that I have a 23-year-old son who is out of the house. Actually, I'm doing very, very well, actually. And I don't know if Darren's here or not, but if he is, I'll get him up later. Is he? I hate when he shows up. I hate when that happens. Everybody says, oh, that was something Joe looked like when he was young. But I'll call Darren up later. This is called I've Had the Time of My Life.
I can't keep you from running. Thank you.
little cheated. Actually, you kidding? You know what I paid.
Anybody here raising teenage children?
Yeah!
Yeah, that's why you're here. Just gotta get out of the house. I'll go anywhere. I'll take the garbage out. I'll drive it out. I gotta get out. Kids are great. He's great. I remember when he was about 10 years old, he used to call me Daddy.
Hi, Daddy. Got any candy?
Then he came about 16, 17. Started saying,
"Hi, Dad. Got any money?"
Then he got to about 19 or 20, he started calling me, "Dude. What's happening, dude? How's the potatoes, dude? They look gnarly. What language is this?" And he's gonna be a doctor. "Would you like going to your doctor?" He says, "Looks pretty gnarly. We're gonna have to rip it out of there, dude." No, he's not gonna be a doctor. Everybody says that he's gonna be a doctor. No, he's not. Okay, let's see. Where's Bobby Gulley? I want to bring up my friend Bobby Gulley. Bobby Gulley, come on, son. Can you sweeten them there? Do we have a microphone for Uncle Bob? For those pants, boy. Big boy. Looks like he's going 30 miles an hour in the closet.
I wasn't going to say anything about those boots.
No, my boots, yes, I know. I can damn near stop anything with those. Even like, boom. Okay, now here's a song that I recorded, well, I don't know, 64. Then I recorded again, last year, somewhere in there. And Bobby was nice enough to come up to the studio and help me out on this song. And I'd just like to say once again, I truly mean this. Bobby Lathrop, he went to Lathrop. And he went to Santa Ana High here. That's the good news. The bad news, it was 10 years after me. But we've become real good friends. He works with me down at the Hop, down in Fountain Valley. We have a little club down there. And we'd like to do... Are you going to sing the second verse? You go second? This is called "You Lost That Love of You." Anymore, one kiss, you're leaving. the old days right there.
Thank you.
Give me an A. Okay, now give me a whole A, like a little. I knew this for my brother and my sister. It's dedicated to my dad who passed away a little over a year ago. Swing, oh, sweet chariot, coming for Kevin. Behold, swinging, oh, sweet chariot, coming for. A song that I recorded back in 68, 69.